The state government says it will buy and demolish thousands of flood-ravaged homes and relocate a major portion of the Lismore population. It's part of a multi-billion dollar fund to future-proof the region against another disaster, while the Hawkesbury Nepean faces a frightening prediction if the Warragamba Dam wall isn't raised.
Imagine owning a 4 or 5 bedroom home that you can't sell.
It must kill you to think that your home is worthless.
Absolutely, absolutely. And we're not well off. We're just trying to scrape by.
For thousands of Lismore locals like Jenna, nobody wants to buy a house that has ended up on the bottom of the Wilson's River a couple of times just this year.
This house, this town should never have been built in the spot where it's been built. And big change has to happen.
For months, locals have been promised a buyback scheme in which the government would purchase their properties.
That is something the government is committed to.
But Dominic Perrottet showed up in town with a 700-page report and still uncertainty. The government says it will buy houses in the most flood-prone areas or allow people to swap their homes for public land.
The floodplain should be recognised as assets, but not assets that we live on.
But the scheme will cost billions of dollars and the detail is yet to be worked out.
There will definitely be an answer before Christmas, and that's important because people are hurting. People put their lives on hold.
The report into February's flood disaster by Mick Fuller and Mary O'Kane put an official end to Shane Fitzsimmons's role. His department, Resilience New South Wales, will be axed.
It just didn't deliver.
But the Premier admits he hasn't called Mr Fitzsimmons to tell him he's been made redundant.
I haven't spoken to him today. I don't make decisions based on people's personalities. I make decisions based on what is right and in the best interest of the people of the state.
I think the Premier of New South Wales at the very least owes Mr Fitzsimmons a phone call.
The SES and RFS will be partially merged and police will have a permanent role in managing disasters. But with more flooding rain expected this summer through another La Nina, these changes need to happen as soon as possible. The report also says without raising the Warragamba Dam wall, there are predictions that with development in the Hawkesbury Nepean Valley over the next 20 years, a 1 in 1,000 year flood could see 46,000 people trapped and hundreds die.
That's something that we can do in to help the families of the Hawkesbury Nepean region.
The dam wall won't be completed for another 10 years, whereas communities in Sydney's northwest need solutions for the next 6 months.
Chris O'Keefe, Nine News.